Thanks for staying with us. We're back. We're now live. Today we're discussing cooking gas. It is now very expensive. I just called my gas man. He says it's I used to buy cooking gas. It used to be 3.5, then it moved to 4,000. Then I think last I bought it was 4. I bought it 4.5 last. Now I spoke to my cooking gas. Now he says it's now 5,500. What happened? We have with us Dr. Yinka Okweke, who is a gas expert, to shed light on this issue of cooking gas, especially now that the country wants to stop us from using other dangerous things like kerosene, and they want to give gas at the cylinders across the country, so because people have found it expensive to use gas cylinders within their houses. Welcome to the show, madam.
Thanks for having me.
Good to have you on the show.
Thank you.
So, I don't even know where to start from, because we know that diesel has been subsidized. We were trying to get them to stop subsidizing fuel. In this case, is gas subsidized or is it not subsidized? Let's start with that.
I think that's a very big question, and I don't even know how to break it down.
Okay.
For starters, I'm not a gas expert. Okay. I'm just a player as well who is as perplexed as you guys at what is going on.
Right.
I'm also a mother, a homemaker, who also has to buy gas.
Yes.
You know? So I kind of like wear two caps.
Good.
You know. And just like you have rightly said, since the onset of our business in the gas industry, we have seen how the prices have steadily increased.
Yes.
And how, unfortunately, the end users are the ones that bear the brunt.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so... Right. Yesterday, we still had a meeting with the Nigeria LPG Association. It's kind of like an association of LPG. And we were eager to listen to an explanation for the hike in prices. But I can tell you for sure, we couldn't categorically say it was this particular reason.
Mm.
But based on so many things and our friends in the industry, you know, interactions with people in the Department of Petroleum Resources and things like that, a lot of them are attributing it, of course, increase in the dollar issue, increase in crude oil. You're talking about logistics issue. They're talking about hoarding because of the VAT that they just pushed on LPG. So just like in PMS, when they're telling you don't want to increase the price, those who have products start holding back on their products.
Mm.
You know? So you have the issue of hoarding. That also increases the price.
Mm.
You have the issue of round tripping when they say that there was something wrong with the LPG vessel. When it has come in, they have to take it back. So it's a...
So for those of viewers who don't know LPG, LPG is just liquefied petroleum gas. So it's gas, no matter.
Yes,
gas.
And this is one
premium
gas.
Yes, right.
Sorry, I just want to. I do hope it's not a stupid question. You know that gas that they are always flaring.
That's it.
Is it not the gas that they are wasting that is inside our cooking pots?
I know, because now a lot of gas is just gaining a lot of attention now, as you would know. So most of the things that we are hearing is from data that we gather, secondary data. Primary data, actually, and then they're saying that we have over 200 million cubic feet of gas that we are yet to flare. You know, so they're trying to say that we have the capacity.
Well done.
However, NLNG Limited, you know, they're saying that they provide 40% of the Nigerian gas, and that's about 370,000 metric tons, you know, by 2020. But they're saying that they will increase the capacity by 2021 to give us more gas and all that. So yes, to answer your question, yes, but is it enough? Are we exploring enough, you know, for domestic use? Apparently not. So that's one language. Availability is one language, and then the price is something else.
Mm-hmm. So, go ahead. For me, for a product that we have in excess, to the extent that we can just burn it and destroy ozone, you know.
Destroy ozone.
Yes, it's anti-productive to our environment. But we allow it happen. How come? And for this long, I remember a cylinder when they were filling a 12.5 for 200 naira. And
Absolutely.
Now, I was a child, yes, I remember when they were filling for 200 naira. And now, suddenly, it became everybody's market. Is it that government suddenly looked at this and then businessmen, because anywhere you have capitalists, profit is the goal, they're looking into this area and focusing and making it more tedious and more difficult for people to access the only petroleum product that is produced here, because we don't have to go and refine gas abroad. We do here and flare it here. Is it that they're now bringing in this ease of doing business and they have businessmen, capitalists in this field?
Ease of doing business. I can't laugh.
So I'm
based in Ashoto, Houston, and here. I'm based in Houston, and I have the smart gas business here.
Okay.
And when you talk about ease of doing business, I laugh. Because I'm sure you and I know,
we know.
That it is non-existent. You know?
Yeah,
people really think I'm crazy coming here to set up Smart Gas at this time. You know, but when you have a passion and you have a purpose, you just have to go with it. To answer your question, it seems very logical to you, the way you said it, that, okay, government is saying let's, you know, promote gas adoption, let's discourage solid fuels like, you know, firewood, charcoal, okay, like yeah. you said. However, on the other hand, how are you making it possible for the average person? Because when we started our business, we do cylinder sales as well. And then we realized, so we do 3 kg, 6 kg, 12.5, 25, and 50 kg. Mm. We realized that the highest selling ones are the 3 kg and 6 kg. Mm. And you would know why. Because the low income earners are the ones who are not adopting it. Mm. You just mentioned that you can't remember when last, you never even used solid fuels. But trust me, charcoal and firewood is the staple for so many families. Mm. Now, they're the ones that are saying, okay, I have increased income. Let me buy 3 kg, let me buy 6 kg. But the truth of the matter is that it's not even affordable. The cylinder is one thing. Mm-hmm. The LPG is another thing. Mm-hmm. So to answer your question, governments, they're saying it theoretically that they want to also adopt it, but they're making it a bit difficult.
From the article I'm reading in the Business Daily, they said that the federal government's plan to launch cylinder project, which will enable Nigerians to buy cheap cylinders, is something that increases. So they understand that the cylinder itself is what dissuades people from using the LPG. But hopefully they give us the cylinders, maybe at a very, very cheaper price, more families will begin to use liquefied gas.
How cheap would the cylinders be? So I am worried that, you know, people are looking for solutions. We have a lot of poor people in our midst. Mm-hmm. And I know that people are beginning to find that we can actually use safe coals as against the one that brings out all those emissions. Mm-hmm. So they make coals from coconut shells, mm-hmm. which is safe. There's no soot. It comes out clean. Clean energy.
Clean energy.
Now, people are looking in that direction because not everybody can afford this gas. Even if it's given free, people may not still be able to refill it. How much is minimum wage that sometimes people don't earn? What do you think the government should do to give other people options? Because this gas thing I'm saying, I don't know how feasible it is.
Honestly, it is. It's in terms of the policies. When you guys were talking the other time, you talked about the importance of having the right people with the know-how who have capacity to understand the issues, you know, to talk about strategies for adoption. So I am all for gas because, like you mentioned abroad, when you turn on your cooktop, it's already piped because there's adequate city planning. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We don't have that now, so there's no point for us to talk about that. But in terms of the cylinders, one of the things that we also do is we try to partner with community leaders to say, you know what, because you have the capacity, buy these cylinders, own it on behalf of the people in your locality. Mm. So that, like you said, the average person doesn't have to buy. They only buy the LPG inside it. Mm. So, for example, you're discussing with an urban an area, and you're saying, you know what, with 5 million naira, for example, we will give you the cylinders because we have our own cylinders too. We'll give you this particular quantity just for your people. Mm. So sometimes when you do some level of collaborations like that, it helps you to be able to give all these other people, you know, gas to use. So is it possible? Yes, it is possible. Mm. And another thing, again, is about the fact of expired cylinders. A lot of explosions. Mm. There's no adequate information. This value chain is really very big, and the information is not out there. The average lifespan of a cylinder is 15 years. A lot of people don't even know. If I ask you, do you know where to check the expiry date of your cylinder? You will not know. You know, so
we're going to break. We're going to talk about the cylinders.
Exactly.
You can have new cylinders. I don't know. I
know, right?
I think we know they buy new. You know that there's a problem. When we come back, we talk about the new ones.
When your guy comes and changes the cylinder for you,
I mark my own. Brown, you cannot stay with us. We'll be right back.
Stay tuned. Your View will be right back.
So, thanks for staying with us. We're talking about gas, cooking gas. I want to bring this conversation home. Madam, you're a gas dealer, and I'd like you to talk about how, first of all, you talked about the gas, I mean, how to check 15 years. This is a picture of the gas cylinder.
He drew
it. I drew it, so you can show us. How, in this cylinder, can you check for the expiration of a gas?
Okay, so for our own cylinders, I'll speak for our cylinders because manufacturers are different. Usually at the cap of the cylinder, so right there, somewhere you will see they would have engraved
the camera
some things there.
Okay.
So they would have engraved some things there. You see the date, the net weight, all those kind of things. And then usually some would do it in terms of, so you can see A, B, C, D. A means like first quarter, January to March.
Okay.
B means that will be April to June, then July to, what's that, September, October, and then October. So your expiration can be like maybe D21. It means maybe the last quarter of 2021. Mm. So that's how you look at that's how you look at the numbers depending on who manufactured it. Yes.
Wow.
So that tells you.
I'm going to go and check my own. But you see, my own, they are so old.
Your own is D 1981.
No, literally. The date is not there again.
And
they are brown. They are just like this.
But let's talk about the quality.
Good.
So I got a new, what is supposedly a new one, mm-hmm. but he said it could have been refurbished. You know those ones that look new? They always line them up in filling stations. Mm-hmm. Those ones, those are the type that was the type I got when I got married. So that one is 12 years old.
Okay.
So
you celebrate your anniversary with
when I got a Tokumbo one, mm-hmm. after, a real, that one measured exactly. I'm telling you, 12 kg. By my gas person advised, madam, this is your cylinder. It looks fragile. Buy this one. And I bought that one till date. That Tokumbo one looks healthier, stronger.
It didn't look.
I don't look dates. So, I just want to check dates.
So this is not about the looks.
Oh my goodness.
Is it about the look or the actual date?
Of course, it's not about the look. You know, so so you have to have testings for your cylinders too. Mm-hmm. They advise that every 5 years. They test the valve, they test the ring to ensure there are no leakages, all those kind of things. Usually it's meant to be people like us, those who are in the gas sector, who probably sell cylinders or who sell gas. When you go and refill, they should be able to do all those testings for you and stuff like that. Exactly.
Yeah,
for example, on our mobile app, we don't do cylinder exchanges for cylinders that are 2016 and older. So if your cylinder is 2015, I'm not going to do an exchange for you.
Okay.
Because our cylinders are new. Our cylinders are standard. I'm not going to change it with yours that you said is 1978. Else, I'm not going to do that.
Because, I'm really 78 now.
So when we buy at gas filling stations, for some gas, there's this black whatever that is removed and changed.
Yes,
some people will just give you like that. You get to start smelling. Isn't that your cylinder is bad? That's why they are changing the rubber.
Sometimes it might not be that. It might just be that it is loose because you're filling and things like that. Mm. Ideally, it's meant to be standard procedure. And that's what I'm trying to talk about. Because we're talking about explosives, it's nice for us to have structured checkpoints, which we don't have. It's a whole lot of things. Mm. The good thing, honestly, where we want to get to, the medium to long-term plan for smart gas, for example, is for us to actually manufacture our cylinders locally. But that, again, comes to ease of doing business and manufacturing companies and the cost of it. The CBN tells you that there's intervention loan for gas adopters and that you have to go through the commercial banks. Then we'll go to the commercial banks and they don't even want to smell it, you know, 9 miles away. And then you're thinking a lot of these things are theory. Mm. They are not practical. Because you're talking about gas adoption, you're talking about availability of funds. But when we are really ready to do these things, one way or the other, it's just...
Let's come back to the issue of the... because I want us to do gas maintenance in the house.
Yeah.
When you buy gas from the roadside, around it's not as full as when you get it from the gas stations. Mm. Why is that? How do we know that I get full gas? Is there any way I, as a homeowner, can measure to be sure that I'm getting full gas?
Mm. Okay, so usually... It's as simple as most people who sell gas should have skills.
Yes. Okay.
It's as simple as that. So when you send your, you know, domestic staff or anybody, or you go there, when they fill it, just have it weighed, you know, to see. A lot of people sometimes will tell you that, I used to buy from that person and it will last me 3 months. When I buy from this other person, it will last me 1 month. I really can't validate that coin.
Okay. When is the cylinder full?
You know?
At the point of purchase. So I buy at a gas plant. This particular guy, I've stopped going there. They would put it on a scale. And they have a measurement just as if they're selling petrol, and you're buying, and it is not full on the meter that I'm counting. And you told me it is full. When exactly is it full? Because I can see it, and because I insist on, if it is not up to 12.5 kg, I know they remove the cylinder. You're now telling me I have to pay more
extra
because I have demanded more. What exactly is the measurement
and how it's full to the brim?
And if your meter say it never reached 12.5, I know we'll come out.
That's a question for the person that did that, you know. Mm. But usually, so for example, one of our cylinders is the size is 20 kg, but it can take capacity of 25 kg.
Okay.
So sometimes they always advise that it shouldn't be, your cylinder will not really be too full to the brim. You understand?
Because
for all those kind of things and all that, because that's why some people, when they finish using their cylinders at home, you know, they close the valve, you know, and then when you want to use it again, you open it. You kind of like have to educate people. So sometimes some people are outrightly dubious. Insincerity comes into play as well. And because the more they sell lower whatever to you, the more they can put something in their pocket. So it's all.
But that water they used to test if it's full. My question is, for the lower income families and homes that would like to really go from kerosene usage or firewood usage to gas, How do they start? I mean, what are the safety precautions they can begin to learn from your experience? What do they do? Because they tell you to put the pipes through this, they put the gas outside, inside.
Yeah.
What are the safety things you can advise us on?
Okay. For the lower income earners, like I mentioned, a lot of them go for the 3 kg and the 6 kg. Okay. Those ones come with burners. Mm. They don't come with a pipe.
Yes.
You know, so they usually don't have. And then, so it's very simple.
Is that safer? Is that safer?
It's not really about safety. I think it's just about the size and what's just... Because it's very small. You know, it's very small, like a stove. So really, you're not going to put a hose there. And then a lot of people put their cylinders outside. Yeah. You're not going to kind of like put... You know, you're doing a 3 kg or 6 kg. Most likely your house is small, your kitchen is small. So it's really just portable and it just has a burner. So it's just for one pot. People like you and I who are doing the 12.5, 25 kg, some 50 kg with large households, use the hose. And then because you can have a 6 burner cooktop.
Right.
You know, yeah. So for those lower income earners, it's easier to manage because it's on and off.
So the size, this size is
12.5. That's very popular for residential.
We all use.
Yeah.
Well, everybody on this table, that's what we use.
Yes.
12.5.
Except me, man, so I went to buy that Tokumbo one that is big.
That she said, and I love refurbished to the much.
I use 50 kg.
Really?
Wow.
What is she cooking? I put it
just
outside.
Take a long
that time. That kind of, if it explodes, now the whole area will carry you.
It's outside the house, and then... It saves me time.
But the manufacturing date is also important. You need to look at that.
People are domestic.
A lot of them.
There is a massive app. They're very dangerous. So.
They're the ones that...
We have
because the piping that you're talking about, you know, when we first moved to Shrine, the government piped, and I'm sure it's all those big companies, they did gas pipe. And that's how they use abroad.
Yes.
Yeah. But can that work in Nigeria? No, I can't trust that one in Nigeria.
Maybe in new localities whereby you can structure.
Even new localities.
You know, where they
go to build that. No, what's going to happen? That blow up the whole new
thing. You can't even break those walls and repair it again. So piping does not
work. Because people don't. So, for example, even yesterday, so I was thinking, where I stay when I'm around, we use electric on our whatever. And the bill, of course, it makes the lights. So, I'm thinking, I do gas. I would like to have gas, but trust me, they configure that place not to use gas. There's even nowhere in the wall that I can pipe to because you want to put your cylinders outside. So I'm stuck with using electricity.
How much?
Let's leave that for another conversation.
We have to wrap up on this, but it's interesting to learn that the government wants to migrate everybody over, I think, over the next 10 years, I believe. I think I read it somewhere. To start using gas. So obviously, they'll start gradually by providing cylinders. We'll wait for them to come up with the blueprint for that. But more importantly, we also need to understand the safety concerning. Any final words for our viewers before we run off?
Okay. For those of you who use gas, as you would know, it's real. Explosions are there. It's very important for you to know the expiration dates on your cylinders. Safety is personal. You start first before you talk about the government.
Gotcha.
We also have our roles to play. You know, so it's very important for that. And of course, be on the lookout for smart gas.
Okay. You want to like their market. Let's go on a break. When we come back, we'll move on to other topics. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Stay tuned. Your View will be right back.